I think all the students in, you know, 10th standard have this issue that some subjects they find interesting and some subjects they find it very boring. Yeah. So even in, you know, in my particular case, I used to find that civics and history as very boring, which is probably the 80% of the case. So how do you deal with it? Because unfortunately or fortunately, every subject or every mark has an equal weightage in the final percentage, right? So you need to study everything. There is no escaping here. So how do you ensure that you get that motivation, okay, to study even those subjects and chapters which you inherently don't like, okay? And the natural tendency typically is you always try to do what you like and try to ignore what you don't like. But here, when you have an exam, you can't be doing that. So any strategy to deal with this particular problem?
So if you're the kind of person who takes up a challenge, you could first take the topic which you're not so comfortable or you don't find it interesting. So as you said, I have many friends who kept saying that I don't like history, civics is very boring. So you could think it of as a story which you would narrate to someone. So this is where group study really comes into play. So as a group, when you're sitting, and mind you, we have to be productive as a group. You assemble as a group and you start going off topic, it didn't help.
Yeah, you can't be discussing movies.
So if you take a subject, you read it and you should be able to explain. So once you start explaining, once you start clearing doubts on that subject, I am pretty sure that you will start, you know, liking that subject and you will be more confident with that subject.
That's amazing advice. So in fact, indirectly you are saying that you become teachers. Right.
Yes.
So if you can teach that topic to someone, right, you would get even better at that topic. That's wonderful advice. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I really love this kid. And I want to give one example. When Please. We were kids, my brother used to say, I don't like brinjal. I don't like. So my father used to tell that, okay, whatever you don't like, okay, first eat that. Then you eat whatever you like. If you fill your tummy with what you like first, then you will never touch the one which you don't like. So first you eat what you don't like. Then eat all that which you like, you keep eating, no problem. This is the advice which goes for learning also. What you don't like, you finish it first, number one. Number two, she's 200% right in this, because anytime peer learning is the best way to learn. What a teacher can't do, a friend can do. Because a teacher, there is an age gap and there is a position gap, and then whatever is said and done, there is an eyebrow and there is an approval gap. Yeah, whereas with a friend, it is not there. Friend takes you as you are. That is the acceptance level. You are saying history, civics. Many children do not like maths. They run, it's a phobia for them. Now, for example, Neha is very good in maths and as well as in telling stories. She can make somebody else learn maths with the stories. Then the child will take it up. It's only in such places the groups work. But the group must be a completely productive group. Now, who will make the group? It is maybe that amongst themselves. But again and again, I say that here parental guidance, parental observation, parental support is required. They have to see, monitor whether really the group is working. If the group is working, encourage them, because the best learning happens in the peers, especially at this point of time. I know that there are the children who are non-performers will pick up like this because of the performers. Neha is an excellent child, for example. She is by all means. And now there is me who not a good performer. Now Neha will be learning by teaching me. She will be telling me that this, that and all. And I may be a learner by listener. Right. So this works beautifully to learn the subject which we don't like.
Right. That's wonderful advice. So, and in fact, again, one of the counterintuitive ones, because, you know, it's always like, you know, consumption. But I think what, you know, the experts and the toppers are saying that you become a teacher, you do a role change, you know, for time being. And if you can be that teacher, by teaching, you'll learn more. And that's awesome advice. Thanks a lot for that.